Today, Apple have announced a major update to Final Cut Pro for Mac. That's version 10.8, as well as a mobile production studio incorporating the iPad and iPhones. The updates will be available for download, using Apple's words, later this spring. But first, let's look at the big news for the Mac version 10.8, which is the use of AI to allow for one-click color improvements for color balance, contrast, brightness, and optimize for SDR, HDR, RAW, and log-encoded media. The new color improvements are similar to the previous balance color command, but it's now seen in the color inspector so that you can see the changes as you tweak them in the inspector. AI has also been employed to generate smooth slow motion. Let's look at what we've got now in 10.7, this frame blending and optical flow, which both slow down a clip to a lower frame rate than it was filmed at. The current optical flow creates new frames between the real frames. And I've got to say, optical flow has been very effective, but it occasionally can produce artifacts and unwanted results. Frame blending simply overlaps the frames on either side. So what can we expect in 10.8? The new smooth slow-mo will use AI to create those missing frames in the video. And this should be even better than the currently acceptable optical flow. The next new feature is a partly welcome addition to Final Cut Pro that lets you change the name of effects and color corrections in the inspector window to something that makes sense to you. And I have to say with a word of warning that you need to either have a good memory or take notes on what the effect was before you rename it and where it came from. Especially when you dig into an old Final Cut Pro library in the future and you need to know where the effect actually was located. On the other hand, I do like the idea of changing the name of a color correction. When you've got several corrections doing different things, just imagine a color curves correction that just affects a face. Now it can be named something like face corrections to differentiate it from that color cast correction. The next feature does really get my approval. I use the paste attributes command frequently. With 10.8, you'll be able to bypass that and be able to drag effects and color corrections directly onto clips in the timeline. That's just brilliant. The last feature needs to be seen to know how useful it actually will be. The release from Apple states that there are new search options in the timeline for missing media and missing effects. I can imagine this could be useful for locating clips in the timeline that have gone offline. The release for 10.8 is scheduled for later this spring, Northern Hemisphere, so it's going to be pretty close. As always, I recommend that you do not update critical production Macs until the 10.8.1 version comes available. And if you just want to see the new version, have a look at my video on how to switch between 10.6 and 10.7. The same applies for switching between 10.7 and 10.8. I haven't detailed them here since we're mainly interested in Final Cut Pro for Mac, but the major differences to the iPad version of Final Cut Pro, they effectively make the iPod and iPhones a fully active mobile production studio with live multicam on the iPad with wireless camera function for the iPhone. These changes to the iPad version of Final Cut have certainly taken the development funds away from Final Cut Pro for Mac. Let's hope more development is directed to the Mac version in the future. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell.